Describing himself as a people-styled administrator, the 51-year-old German-born Dr. Stephen Bering assumed the helm of one of the nation's most respected universities, replacing acting Purdue president John Hicks. In his casual but no-nonsense approach, Dr. Bering went right to the point with reporters. Higher education, he said, is under the gun. Challenged with a new worldwide economy, an explosion in technology, and the pressing need of re-educating the adult population. More specifically, Bering said Indiana has done an average job of getting its young people through high school. The problem, he said, is at the college level.
It's not sufficient to be a high school dropout and make a success as a citizen and as a wage earner in the kind of society we're living in and will have. An education has not only intrinsic merit, but has a true payoff in terms of the jobs that you can get and the kind of earning capacity that you will have and the style and quality of life that you can have.
On the issue of attracting and retaining good teachers, Bering said schools must encourage a disciplined classroom atmosphere, provide the latest in equipment and technology, along with one other very necessary ingredient.
We are going to have to put our money where our mouth is and give teachers competitive salaries. If we believe that they are the important molders of young talent for the future, then they need to be recognized as important by being given competitive salaries.
Specifically for Purdue University, Bering foresees an increased role in assisting industry and the state with research and development and economic growth. As evidence, Bering made this revelation.
Last week, we hosted a foreign subsidiary of a famous American high-tech company, and they're considering coming to Lafayette and to Indianapolis simultaneously. And I think we can get that done. And why are they looking here? Well, they're looking here because of Purdue University. Why are they looking in Indiana in the first place? It's the spirit that I think is now in evidence all over the place, that as you look at downtown Indianapolis, you can't help but feel that there's a vibrance and an alive new renaissance which is at work in everything that you look at. And it isn't just amateur sports.